শ্রুতি স্মৃতি পুরাণাদি পাঞ্চরাত্রিং বিধিং বিনা ঐতান্তিক ঐকান্তিক হরির ভক্তি উৎপাতৈব কল্পতে। শ্রুতি স্মৃতি পুরাণাদি পাঞ্চরাত্রিং বিধিং বিনা ঐকান্তিক হরির ভক্তি উৎপাতৈব কল্পতে। অ্যাকচুয়ালি শ্রীশিল ভক্তি সিদ্ধান্ত সরস্বতী গোস্বামী ঠাকুর প্রভুপাদ টোল্ড, প্রিচিং ক্যান বি ডান বোথ ওয়ে, নেগেটিভ অ্যান্ড পজিটিভ ওয়ে, আই অলরেডি টোল্ড। শঙ্করাচার্য অলসো প্রিচিং, রামানুজাচার্য প্রিচিং, মাধ্যাচার্য প্রিচিং, বিষ্ণুস্বামী প্রিচিং, নিম্বার্কাচার্য প্রিচিং, ভাস্করাচার্য প্রিচিং, এভরিবডি প্রিচিং। But actually, people are in confusion. People, they cannot understand how to accept the actual tattva. What is the procedure? You can remember the sloka I started with. Prabhupada used to discuss this sloka, that Shruti Siddhi Puran exact extract, who can understand? Who can understand the actual meaning of Shastra? Is rare. So now it is, here it is spoken, that Shruti, Sriti, Puran, everything what prescribing actually, without that, those who are going to sow bhakti, it is one kind of nonsense. Problem created in the society, nothing else. You know, today is the appearance day of Madhvacharya ji, Madhvacharya. Also, today is Dasami Tithi, and Sri Ramchandra going to cross the ocean, going to Sri Lanka, yes, today, actually. So today is very important day. Also, Devi Dham, in this Devi Nam, those people, they are worshipping Devi, and today they are Devi going away, at present, today, actually. So today is the appearance day of Sri Madhvacharya ji. Who is Madhvacharya, you know already? Madhvacharya is the incarnation of principal Vayu, Mukha Vayu avatar. In Teta Yuga, Mukha Vayu came in the form of Hanumanji Maharaj. And in Dapar Yuga, in the form of Hanuman, in the form of Bhimsen. And this Kalikal, actually Madhvacharya coming in the Mukha Vayu coming in the form of Madhvacharya. Why Madhvacharya coming? What is the reason? Actually, in Mahabharata you can find, in Mahabharata Banaparva, you can, Banaparva, I forget, you can find that Pitamaha Vishwa, while giving advice to Yudhishthir Maharaj, everybody, last time, then Pitama Vishwa forecast that after 400 years over of Kali, again Panchapandav can come. Pitama Vishwa already forecast. After 400 years of Kali running, and 400 years over, then actually Panchapandav can come in some other form. So from today you can, exact calculation not available. Somebody saying this, somebody saying this, but anyway, tentative calculation is that 800 years back, more or less, 800 years back, Sri Madhvacharya ji came in this material world to restore actual Siddhanta, to establish actual Siddhanta. He came here. There was so much problem in society before his coming. So much problem. You don't know actually, Shankaracharya came first in Kaladi village near Trivandrum long ago. First Shankaracharya came. Then again Shankaracharya came at the time of Madhvacharya. That time his Avirbhav was there in Kumbakonam near Trivandrum, one place in Kerala. There again Shankaracharya came at the time of Madhvacharya. There was big competition because Madhvacharya came, actually Madhvacharya came by the mercy of Supreme Lord to establish Dvaita Siddhanta, and Shankaracharya all along actually speaking about Advaitabad. Shankaracharya always speaking there is nothing. Only Brahma is there and nothing else. All these material worlds, everything was false. Everything false. And what about this jiva? But jiva eva Brahma na para. Jiva Brahma, nothing else. Jiva is Brahma. This kind of Siddhanta was established by Shankaracharya. First Shankaracharya, he started speaking. By the order of Supreme Lord, he came here to establish Dvaita Siddhanta, Advaita Siddhanta, to misguide all those who are asuric people, those who are demonic character. It was the order, he received order from Supreme Lord. Hey Shankar, you will have to go to this material world. Those who are with demonic bhava, you will have to misguide them. You will have to represent Siddhanta in such a way so that they are bound to accept that. They cannot realize. So this way actually Shankaracharya came. So that was also very important because that time Buddhists, they was putting so much influence in society. Nobody going to accept anything except Buddhism. So influence. So by the mercy of Supreme Lord, Shankaracharya came here to at least establish Veda. Importance of Veda. Though in Chaitanya Charitamrita it is written, Mahaprabhu speaking, that what Shankaracharya Mayavad Bhashya, it is more dangerous than Buddhism. How? Why? Mahaprabhu speaking, Ved mukhe mayavad bauddho ke odhik. Ved mukhe mayavad bauddho ke odhik. Buddhists, they openly ignore Veda. It's okay, no problem, we can be careful about that. But those who are mayavadis, Shankaracharya and their followers, they are putting Veda in front of them. You see, we are going to follow Veda. But they are not going to follow Veda actually. They are going to insult Veda. They are going to misinterpret Veda. Veda, Upanishad, Gita. But Bhagavad Srimad Bhagavad Gita Mahapuran, he couldn't touch. Because Bhagavad Ji Mahapuran is dangerous, full of bhakti. It is dangerous for him. That's why Bhagavad Ji Mahapuran he couldn't touch. He never take help of Bhagavad Ji Mahapuran, any documents, anything, because anyhow he cannot establish Mayavad. Anywhere he is going to touch Bhagavatam, he cannot establish. That's why he is live, avoid Bhagavatam. Except that Upanishad and Gita, and other, you know, they are Vedanta, they are going to explain in such a way so that you cannot disbelieve. You can think that they are right. So nice explanation. So, for the time being, Shankaracharya avatar, Shankaracharya came, but that was also in, has some importance for the time being. But actually, it is dangerous. Mahaprabhu speaking, they are keeping Ved in front, but actually they are going to ignore all Guru Tattva, Bhagavat Tattva, everything. Nothing, they believe. Now Madhvacharya was deputed by Supreme Lord for this reason, with full power. So Madhvacharya came here at least 800 years back, maybe some plus minus, 800 century, 800 years back, in Kumbhakonam, Karnat Pradesh, not actually, Pajakhetro. It is actually Pajakhetro, one place. Actually, you can remember, Parshuram when killing all Kshatriya and making pond, five pond in Kurukshetra, near Kurukshetra, Samanta Panchak it is called. Then after that, he was traveling here and there in India, different pilgrimage. So he is Supreme Lord, incarnation of Supreme Lord, Shaktavish Avatar. And that time he went there, and by the power of bow and arrow, he sent sea backside. You go backside. I like to make big land. There was actually sea that time. So by his own power, bow and arrow, sent back, go back, sea go back. Then he make a nice piece of land, big land. There also he make one pond also, very nice. And that piece of land, big land, was distributed by Parshuram to Brahman Vaishnava. This way. And that place there, one place is that named Pajakhetro. It's a very important place. There actually, Madhvacharya, principal by Mukshabayu avatar, came. And the house of Narayan Bhatto and Vedvati. Mother Vedvati and Narayan Bhatto, very high class Brahmin family. They are actually two or three of their boys dying. So they are taking resolution that we want to get such a boy who is not going to die anymore. Is it possible? Because two, three boys already taking birth and dying. Father, mother, very sorry, always crying how to live. After that, they are taking resolution for 12 years. They are taking only milk and doing austerity and penance, heavy. They are doing heavy austerity and 12 years only milk, nothing else. After that, Supreme Lord was pleased by the austerity and penances and blessed them. So shortly, actually, Madhvacharya, Mukhobayu avatar, came here as a son of Vedvati Ma or Narayan Bhatta. His boy was very powerful, child, but so healthy, nice. But after that, actually, that boy, when growing up, they are feeling some doubt. Who that boy is? So powerful, extraordinary power. Childhood, only one time reading, ka, learn, done. One time. Everything done. Then after that, gradually growing up, that boy. And the name of that boy was Vasudev. The name of the boy was Vasudev by Narayan Bhatta. He keep the name, very nice name, Vasudev. So the bad growing up, and very shortly he complete all preliminary backer and everything complete. Then going to take higher education, three miles away northeast, I think, I forget, there, from a very nice Pandit, Brahman Pandit, very Shuddha, learning everything, Veda, Vedanta, everything, learning. After that, he come back, and always from childhood, he was so strange, his behavior was so strange, nobody can understand, how possible. Madhvacharya, when he was Vasudev, very small boy, he going there for reading, I mean, learning Veda, Vedanta, everything, scriptural analysis too. But there, the teacher was very strict. But Madhvacharya, I mean, this boy is always busy with playing. All the time playing. No attention in reading. Those boys reading, he is not reading properly. He is playing always. Then one day, the teacher, professor, very hard, chide him. Hey! What you are doing, always playing? No reading, nothing. What for you have come? Then with appealing hand, standing in front of Gurudev and speaking all Veda, Vedanta reciting. What already read, what not already out of, you know, syllabus already. Out of syllabus, he already passed and visual. Going, went on speaking. Acharya looking, what? This boy? What I teach them is speaking, what not only taught as yet, went on speaking. The teacher became, why? How possible? Then after taking lesson, he come back to home. And after that, Narayan Bhatta was very pleased. Narayan Bhatta planning, because any family man, they are planning. I can arrange marriage of my boy, I can arrange this, that. Family man always planning. So father planning something. And the boy actually speaking in front of father. Father, I am going to break Mayava Siddhanta and establish Bhakti Siddhanta. I mean Dvaita Siddhanta. Father laughing. How you can do a small boy? How it is possible for you? It's not at all possible for you. Actually one dry, you know, piece of, you know, wooden piece was there. One piece of one tree, dry piece, one, log in hand, small. And Narayan Bhatta speaking, if it is at all possible for you that this small piece of dry, you know, part of this tree can take the form of a big trees, then I can believe that you can break Mayavad Siddhanta and establish Bhakti Siddhanta, Dvaita Siddhanta. Otherwise, how possible? Quite impossible. Vasudev said, yes, Father, it is possible by the mercy of Supreme Lord. He put that piece of, you know, log into ground. Immediately that became a big banyan tree. Big banyan tree. Father, you know, maybe it is possible. Maybe it is possible for you. Now I cannot disbelieve. Maybe it is possible for you. Anyway you try. Father, I can do it. You can see. After that, Narayan Bhatta watching day by day, that boy is, you know, tilting, I mean, towards Supreme Lord. His symptom is not good. Maybe he can take sannyas and run away, so I can arrange marriage for this boy. Father, planning is going so Siddhanta, nice, so power, and always showing some detachment. So maybe he can run away from family, so I can arrange marriage. He is watching how to arrange marriage. In that time, Vasudev could realize the father and mother planning this way. So without giving any information, one day flying from home. It is written in somebody speaking, even you take diksha, even you take sannyas, you will have to take permission from your father and mother. Somebody speaking, I am not speaking. But it is totally wrong. For Supreme Lord, I can give my life any time, any moment. There is no aparad. There is no, it is not at all sinful activities. Somebody speaking this way. Actually, Supreme Lord, it is a standing instruction of Supreme Lord. It is a standing instruction of Supreme Lord. Man nimittam kitam papam dharmaya kalpate. If any sinful activity you are going to do for me, it is not at all sinful activity. It is pious activity. Dharma. What about pious activity? Not even pious activity. It is dharma. But all dharma, what is mean by dharma? Dharma is Krishna. If you touch Krishna, okay, dharma is there. If you detach from Krishna, the adharma is there. So what do you mean by dharma and adharma? Krishna already giving instruction. Manvittam kritam papam dharmaya kalpate. Even somebody going to do some sinful activity for me, still it is not. I already told, no? Jodu, already avoid father. No, I cannot take your old age. Not possible. Actually, in Veda it is the pita, dharma, pita, it is written. But for Bhagavad Dharma, it is not applicable here. So somebody is speaking, you must take permission from father, mother, everybody, before taking sannyas, everything. But it is totally wrong. Because in this material world, it is the target of father and mother, when they are giving birth to a boy, they have some expectation that we are going old age gradually. Someday that boy can grow up and take responsibility. Our responsibility can take. So everybody in the society, the system, father, mother, they have some plan. My son is there, so I can take advantage of his, you know, seniority. He can grow up, help me in my old age. This is a system in material world. Also, father and mother, if they are going to join devotional life, then son, if material, they are going to put some problem. Why you are going, what they are useless this way? This is the system here. So, Madhacharya, are you in Vasudeva, actually living, gone, fly from home. And going to Rajatpur, one place, long distance from there. He is taking mantra diksha and sannyas from Achyuta Preksha. He is taking mantra and everything and sannyas, everything from Achyuta Preksha. From Achyuta Preksha he took sannyas, everything. After that started preaching in a heavy, heavy way. In between there was big problem. Why? Because that time those who are Mayavadis, because South India actually, you can find Mayavadi big, that field is Mayavadi. Maximum people, Mayavadi. Some of them Ramanuja, some of them Ramanuja Sampradaya, some of them Madhva Sampradaya they are doing, but most of those people, they are Mayavadi. So that time, actually, first Shankaracharya, I am speaking about. First Shankaracharya. Second time Shankaracharya came. So, when I am going to speak, the second Shankaracharya came, then they are going to demand that Shankaracharya came again. Okay. Then if Shankaracharya again coming back, how it is possible? Because you say, when you become Brahma, when you be jiva Brahma napara, so you speaking jiva is Brahma. So, Brahma going to become Brahma. How it is possible the Shankaracharya to come back? So I can prove that they are liar. In their sampradaya itself, they are demanding, they are speaking, that Shankaracharya again come back. So they are speaking lie. Follow? So Shankaracharya when going to leave body, then Padmapad Adi, so many big disciple, Padmapad Adi, Shankaracharya, going to leave body, they are all standing around Gurudev and asking Gurudev, what is your last order to us? Shankaracharya speaking, you see, the reason for why I come here, I was trying to do, and again, you will have to also do. What? But actually, you will have to preach Mayavad Siddhanta, I mean, Advaitabad, very strictly. And there is big problem. Because those, Vaishnava Acharyas, they are going to make problem. So you will have to be very careful about that. So it was a standing instruction of Shankaracharya. What to speak about second Shankaracharya? He also same mood. He came, he same Shankaracharya came, same mood. Only this place he took birth and now this place. Follow? Kalad, this village and now Kumbakonam. Little different. But same Shankaracharya coming. There is also one mode. One temple, big temple is there. There you can find one big temple. There. So actually they are putting great operation against those who are preaching Dvaitavad. So this is big problem. They are fighting and you know they are kidnap them, putting them in captive and bound them to pronounce Swaham, Swaham. You have to live that mantra. You will have to speak Swaham. Swaham means Mayavadi mantra. This problem, big problem. Peak problem actually there. That time, his a big acharya there in the line of Achyutapekha I told already. That time, long ago, before Madhvacharya took bath. That time, Achyutapekha was there, his Gurudev was there. His name was Gyan Ki something, I forget his name. Because so disturbance I come here. I propose to speak so many things, I forget. So many disturbance. Plan actually. So he took, actually he was there and all those, you know, Mayabad, you know, those people, they are coming and they are giving fire to their temple. They set fire to their temple and they burned all Dvaita Siddhanta. Many books was compiled before, were compiled. Dvaita Siddhanta, very nice collection. But they set fire in temple, they burned. And after that, Achyutapekha and his Gurudev, Gyan something, I forget. I can remember. They are in trouble. They put, you know, big problem on them. You will have to, you know, chant this mantra, Soham. They make Pundrik, this Tilak, like Ravan. They take Tilak. They force him. They are crying. If we fight with them, we are in number, we are, you know, we cannot, they are, you know, big. Their number, their party is big. So better we can stay in guise. So they take Pundarik, everything, and inside they are doing Krishna bhajan, very secretly Narayan bhajan, but outside they are not speaking anything. Somehow they manage. After that, in the meantime, when Madhvacharya took birth there, Pajakheto, automatically they are feeling some power inside heart. Nobody knows why. When Madhvacharya in the meantime took birth by that time, then they are feeling some power inside. Some. Like when Mahaprabhu took birth here, Advaita Gosvami Haridas Thakur dancing. Why dancing? What reason? Advaita Acharya dancing. Some reason is there. So here also, some reason, they are feeling some power. After that, Madhvacharya growing up and started preaching, you know, and he came in front of Achyutapekha. 1 year he was trained to serve Achyutapekha, and in front of Gurudev, by the mercy of Gurudev, he was singing all the Siddhanta of Dvaitavad. He was speaking continuously 1 year, serving Gurudev. Gurudev could realize that he is the fittest person to break all Mayava Siddhanta, he can establish. In the meantime, actually, with some disciples, in the meantime, Madhvacharya also started making disciples. In the, somewhere it is written, in the at the age of 11, he took sannyas. Somewhere it is written, at the age of 12 only, he took sannyas. After taking sannyas, he is preaching massive way. Nobody can fight with him. He is preaching And in the meantime, he took decision to go to Badrikasram with all his disciples. With all his disciples, long distance, going to Himalayan place, there in Badrikasram. There in Badrikasram, he is sitting in one place at the bank of Saraswati Nadi and Badrinarayan Bhagavan. There he is reciting Gita. He is reciting Gita. That time, all disciples and he could realize there's some blue color, deep blue color, some light coming. And when Madhvacharya explaining, this light coming and submerged with the mouth of Madhvacharya, automatically. Those disciples become stunned, how possible? Madhvacharya could realize that this is the instruction of Vyasadeva to come to his place. So he leave all disciples, you stay here, I am coming from there, Vyasa Gufa. Then Madhvacharya along going to Himalayan place, Gufa, Vyasa Gufa, and pay dandavat. At the same time, he find Vyasadeva Goswami coming out to bless him. He pay prostrated on the one, the Vyasadeva bless him fully and give power. Then Madhvacharya again coming back and started writing so many Vasya of Kathopanishad, Taittiriya, Aittiriya, Brihadaranyak, Gita. Follow, he started explaining so many books. So many books. Very nice Siddhanta started establishing. Nobody can stand in front of you. Big, big Mayavad Acharya, Buddhi Sagar Adi. Big, big Mayavad Sang. Big. They also coming in front of him, but they become defeated in front of him. One day, Shankaracharya going to take darshan of Rameshwaram. Rameshwaram. There, in one temple, Swayanpadanabho, this kind of name. There in temple, near Kumbakonam, now some place. There he was explaining Vedanta, theistic Vedanta. I mean, Daito Siddhanto. That time, second Shankaracharya was bound to come here, run here, and protest. You cannot speak this way, because you have no Vasya. You have no Vasya, you cannot speak this way. Without Vasya, how is speaking? Madhvacharya speaking, where is this kind of Siddhanta? That without Vasya, I cannot speak? I can show you Sasa Siddhanta all. If you have your power, you come and sit in front of me and discuss. I can give all documents from different sastra. Then Shankaracharya just started fighting with Madhvacharya. Madhvacharya one by one going to cut his all Mayavad Siddhanta, establish his own Siddhanta, and Shankaracharya, second Shankaracharya was totally defeated. Then Shankaracharya was defeated. Madhvacharya got more and more power to preach, you know, Daito Siddhanta. Again, second time, Madhvacharya went to Vyasa Gufa. Again, Madhvacharya. Then there, actually, Madhvacharya giving all lessons of Vedanta, everything. Second time, again going. Then there. All the actual Tattva Siddhanta of Vedanta, Upanishad, everything taught. Then again, Prem Dandavat coming back. After they started writing all Vedanta Vasya, everything. Started writing everything, all. Mane Vedanta Vasya, everything. Started writing. So Madhvacharya was just so powerful, nobody can come in front of me, can stand. Even those demigods, one time he was explaining Brihadaranyaka Upanishad in one place, very nice place. That time all demigods, they are coming in heaven. They are very much interested to hear the, you know, interpretation, I mean, Vasya. They gone mad. And from there, they are throwing Pariyat Pushpa from heaven. Nobody can see where from flower coming. All demigods throwing flower on it. They are so impressed, so mad. So this way, Madhvacharya now going to establish his Siddhanta, very nice way. In the meantime, I am bound to say that we are Madhva Gauri Sampradaya. In our Sampradaya itself, some Mayavadi there. In our Sampradaya itself, some Mayavadi is there. They are not going to believe. They are not going to believe that we are having any connection with Madhvacharya. They are always speaking, no, we have no connection with Madhvacharya. It is actually Baladev Vidyabhusan. He was bound to make one connection with Madhvacharya. Actually, we have no connection. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, very heavily speaking, those who are going to ignore, those who are going to ignore the relationship of Gauriyas with Madhvacharya, they are actually Kali Gupta Chor. They are the spy of Kali. Actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking heavily. Those who are going to ignore, they are not going to believe that we have any connection with Madhvacharya. They are actually Kali. They are the spy of Kali. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking this way. So we have connection with Madhvacharya. So many Siddhanta I can establish one by one, but time cannot permit, I know. So I am going to speak very in gist. One point is that Madhvacharya, one day Madhvacharya was going to sea, take bath. In between, when going to take bath in sea, in between he write one very nice book. He speak Krishna Stotra. While going to take bath to sea, up to this, five chapters there, Krishna Stotra, about Krishna, glorification of Krishna. Yes, only going to take bath. In the meantime, he recite, write and everything. After taking bath, he was doing some bhajan there. In the meantime, one big ship was in problem. Because the ship cannot move. There was full of items. That ship was supposed to go to some place for business purpose. And the owner of the ship is gone mad. How we stuck up here, stand still, stagnant condition, I cannot move. Then they are in big problem, they are crying, oh God, how to go, somehow we in problem. And they find one big sadhu, Madhvacharya, he pray. We are in problem, he pray. If you please help us, then we can give you some gift. Madhvacharya is laughing. I am less interested about gift. Madhvacharya is showing some signal. I mean, some gesture with hands, with full power. Automatically, that ship floating in water, immediately. Automatically floating and started moving. And they wanted to give big tilak, one rock of tilak, big tilak. Big tilak, chandan, gopi chandan. They are giving to Madhvacharya. Can you take? You say yes, you give. Madhvacharya, they are all people, very forcefully. They are giving. Madhvacharya taking one hand. And taking, somehow it was slipped from hand. And break, I find there is one Nitya Gopal, very nice Gopal there. Very nice, very beautiful Gopal. You can go mad to see the beauty of Gopal. What kind of Gopal? Dadhimanthan, Danda, Yashoda, I'm in front of Yashodama coming, Gopal just break his sleep and become very angry. But because hungry, that's why angry. And going to approaching mother with very, you know, and going to mother, looking at mother, and without speaking anything, catch the Danda. Now you have no right to, you know, star, you have only duty to give me. Then Yashoda Ma started giving milk, breast milk. This is the this mood. I mean, catching the danda with dancing mood and very gambhir, very silent. This murti. Madhvacharya. So Madhvacharya then was very happy. Then taking this deity to his temple, Udupi one place. And you should remember one thing more, that Madhvacharya already worshipping one deity of Ramchandra from long time. Nobody knows. That deity was worshipped by Dasaraji Maharaj. It was already there. Dasaraji Maharaj in Treta Yuga used to worship that deity, Ramchandra. So also somehow it was there. So Madhvacharya already worshipping that, and now Gopal already coming. And naturally, whereas he is Hanuman, Hanuman without worshipping Ramchandra, how can live? So Ramchandra there already. And Gopal is also there, writing Gopal Tattva, everything. Nobody can measure the power of Madhvacharya. Nobody can measure the power. How possible? So powerful. But he is like ordinary human being. One man, he is very, very, he is practicing wrestling, you know, kusti. His man, he is 35 men, so 30 men is equal to one man. He is saying 30 men can come in front of me. They cannot do. So powerful. 35 men or 35 men is equal to one man. Not even that. So powerful. He is challenging Madhvacharya. Hey, I can fight you. Madhvacharya, I have no time to fight with you, but I can, you can test me. Yes, I can test you. What is your power? Madhvacharya, okay. If you, I can fight with you, if you can move my, you know, fingertips. Only if you can move my fingertips, then I can fight with you. Okay? Then what is the leg, fingertips? The main fingertips? Throne. Is putting there, Madhvacharya. Now if you have your power, you can move it. He with full power, sweat coming, cannot move. Cannot move even nothing. But to speak, so powerful. Madhvacharya laughing. Only put the leg here, and you just move it. Cannot move. One day, temporary bridge was broken, and water coming, and all village people they are going to a place to catch one big rock. 1,000 people catching that rock, like you know, Sagar Manthan. All demigods and gods, they are catching Mandarachal Parva. In the meantime, they break. Oh, we cannot, it's not possible for us, so heavy. Then Bhagavan coming and catching in one hand, taking and now, what problem? We cannot carry this. Okay, I'm coming. Then Bhagavan taking this Mandarachal Parva and putting here. Similarly, Madhvacharya watching thousands of people, they are pushing, dancing, to bring this rock here to make a temporary arrangement so that water cannot come at least. Madhvacharya, they are failure totally. Madhvacharya, what problem? Well, we cannot carry. Okay, go. He taking in one hand this big rock and coming here and put in there. This way Madhvacharya, you cannot estimate the power of Madhvacharya. So powerful, oh my God. It's Hanumanji. Then how possible actually Hanumani Maharaj, why you are powerful? This way Madhvacharya, one by one, saying so much miracles is showing one by one. Now actually, at last, you know, in Udupi Khetro, he established one nice mart. There you can go and see that Gopal is already there and arrange the system of worshipping. Now our Gaudiya devotees, some of them, they are having some Mayavad Siddhanta, they are speaking, we have no connection with Madhvacharya. But whereas, you know already, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing is Parikrama Khanda, the Madhvacharya already came here in Navadip Dham. Shankaracharya also came. Shankaracharya came time to time. Maybe Shankaracharya before. Ramanujacharya came. Vishnu Swami came. Nimbarkacharya came. Madhacharya came. All they came here in Gauranga, Gaur Dham to get kripa. When Madhacharya came, then Mahaprabhu was, you know, very pleased and promised in front of Madhacharya, in Kalikal, this Kalikal, I am going to accept your sampradaya. In Kalikal, I am coming to accept your sampradaya. Mahaprabhu speaking. Also, you can fight that how possible, because Mahaprabhu came only 500 something years back. Madhacharya came long ago, you stole. By the Maharaj, Gaur Vigraha is Nitya. Not that Mahaprabhu came only 550 years back. This is not calculation. Actually, Nitya Gaur Vigraha is there. So, Nimbarkacharya also gave the darshan of Mahaprabhu, Chatuswan. From Chatuswan, it was, you know, Chatuswan already came here. Saptarshi already came here. They all came here in Gaur Dham. So, this kind of fighting is obsolete. You cannot fight this way. So, Madhvacharya came. Mahaprabhu speaking, in Kalikal, I am coming here and I am going to accept your sampradaya. This is the system. And some people saying Madhvacharya is going to give connection, but not that. They actually, why Mahaprabhu was bound to accept this sampradaya? Because you can remember, we can say that Shankaracharya, his sampradaya, going to preach Advaitavad. And Ramanujacharya going to establish Shuddhadvaitavad. Visishtadvaitavad. Visishtadvaitavad. Shuddhadvaitavad by Vishnu Swami. This way, you see, Vishnu Swami Shuddhadvaita Siddhanto. And this way, actually, you know, what is it? Madhvacharya, Dvaita, Shuddhadvaita, Ramanujacharya actually Visishtadvaita, Ramanujacharya. Madhvacharya actually Shuddhadvaita. Now, actually, here, Madhvacharya Dvaitavadi, Dvaitavadi. And Nimbarkacharya Bhedvadi, Ramanujacharya Visishtadvadi, and Advaita and Shankaracharya actually Kevala Advaitavadi. This way they are. So actually Mahaprabhu, when came, he was bound to make some reconciliation. Because there are some scientific difference. All four Acharya, they are giving some Siddhanta. Among them, some little difference was there. Somebody speaking this way, somebody speaking that way. So from Ramanujacharya, Mahaprabhu took Shakti Siddhanta, and from Madhvacharya he took what? Sachidananda Vigraha. Sachidananda Vigraha, this tattva, was established in Madhvacharya Sampradaya. So he taking this, and from actually Nimbarka, some Madhvacharya Dvaitavadi, actually Vishnu Swami, Shuddhadvaita Siddhanta, Sarvasa, Nimbad, and Nimbarka, Nitto Dvaitadvaita Siddhanta, Nitto Dvaitadvaita Siddhanta. This way, one by one, from Ramanujacharya he took Shakti Siddhanta, Madhvacharya this Nitya Vigraha, this Vichar. This way Mahaprabhu giving one Siddhanta, it is called actually Achinta Vedavet Tattva. So Achinta Vedavet Tattva was established by Mahaprabhu, and Jiva Goswami Pad going to break some Siddhanta. Ramanujacharya speaking that in Brahma, there is actually some, in Brahma, Jiva Goswami was speaking, there cannot be different category. One Brahma is one, But Ramanujacharya speaking that this Jagat, the material world, and Jiva, that's a Vishesh, the speciality. There is the Vishesh of Brahma. When Jiva, countless Jiva there, and this material world, so these two are the theory, Vishesh and speciality of this Brahma. That is why they are called Vishishta Dvaitavad. But Jiva Goswami was speaking, there cannot be, you know, different kind of items there, is one. Because Brahma mean one. Shuddho, Chit Brahma. There cannot be heterogeneous item, homogeneous, actually, one. This way Jiva Goswami Pad, according to the desire of Mahaprabhu, was bound to establish this Achinta Vedavet Tattva. So, Madhvacharya in whole life, writing so many Siddhanta up to 79 years, Madhvacharya was alive in this material world. Within that period, even more than Ramanujacharya. Ramanujacharya was a strong bull against Mayavad. But still, Madhvacharya was more. Because Ramanujacharya already write, you can find one Siddhanta there in their own book, Parapakho Giribajra. Ramanujacharya wanted to break Mayavad totally. But Madhvacharya was more. And one thing more, there is Sachidananda Vigraha, their loveful service. Madhvacharya already approved loveful service. Even Prabhupada writing in his one article that Madhusudan Goswami, he went to there in Udupi, he writing letter to Prabhupada that there one branch of Acharya. Branch of Acharya, 8 or 7 or 8. They are all dancing in front of Supreme Lord. Follow during Arati. They are like Gopi. They are doing this. So they accept Gopi Bhav. Also, Krishna Hite Chaturmukh, Hai Krishna Sevamukh, Bhama Hite Naradero Murti, Narada Hite Vyas, Madhugaya Vyas. This way we are running. So actually somebody is speaking that where from Brahma getting this Rastatta? They are fighting this way. So actually when Brahma got this mantra, what? Ashtadashakshar mantra. Mantraj. When Brahma got this mantra from Krishna, Krishna is the Chaturmukh, sweet. So when Brahma got only mantra, this mantra he got from Bhagavan Sri Krishna. So Ashtadashakshar mantra, in this mantra, Kam Gayatri, everything there. Follow? Kam Bhi. So how it is possible that Brahma not going to get? Madhacharya in Madhva Sampradaya, actually Brahma is topmost. Follow? Brahma is topmost. From Brahma they are actually coming. I can discuss someday. Today so much disturbance. So from Madhacharya actually one by one this is coming. So they can fight basically where from he is getting this. Actually when Madhacharya, when actually Brahma getting this mantra, so through parampara automatically Madhacharya is already having this mantra. So in Gaudiya Sampradaya they are having this rasa tattva, rasa bhajan. How we can deny it? It's possible. So it's not that actually our Baldev Vidya Bhushan making some connection with that. Not that. It's a wrong conception. Anyway, so much thing I wanted to speak, but due to disturbance, I like to stop today. So any question if you have, you can put. Madhvacharya, at the age of 79, he left body and gone away, but still today we are having this parampara line. So, today I am going to stop. No.
Maharaj, I have also heard that Srila Prabhupada,
Sweat coming. আস্তে করে চালাও। হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ, অ্যাট দ্য টাইম বিশ্ব বৈষ্ণব রাজসভা, অ্যাট দ্য টাইম প্রভুপাদ, বিশ্ব বৈষ্ণব রাজসভা মিন্স ফ্রম ডিফারেন্ট সম্প্রদায় দে আর ইনভাইটেড টু কাম অ্যান্ড জয়েন অ্যান্ড এক্সপ্রেস দেয়ার ওন ওপিনিয়ন। অ্যাট প্রেজেন্ট নো বডি কামিং। বিশ্ব বৈষ্ণব রাজসভা মিন ইউ উইল হ্যাভ টু কল অল সম্প্রদায়, অল অ্যাট লিস্ট ফোর সম্প্রদায় দে আর কামিং। So but now nobody coming. Vishwa Vaishnava Rasama, how you can run? Vishwa Vaishnava Rasama means you have to call all Sampradaya. They can sit, they can discuss, exchange some view, Siddhanta Vichar, then. But at present it is totally off. Follow what I say? It was, that time it was possible. Big, big Prabhupada was there, big, big Acharya there. At present who can? And why? Then nobody going to obey. Because we are not able to maintain our dignity. That is also one point. Follow what I say. We'll have to some relation with them. Maybe they are following this, but still we should have connection with them. This way we are begging.